I just want to talk a little bit about the role of Christian men, or role of the fathers, or fathers to be. If we think deeply, we will remember that Saint Joseph, the foster father of our Lord Jesus Christ, was a carpenter, and we can also tempt Jesus to be a carpenter. So I think he learned the trade from his foster father, Joseph. And that is to tell us how influential men can be to their children and to the people around them. If we fathers, or fathers to be, know that we are pillars of the home, we will always be dedicated to the service of God. And there's something that strikes me about fathers or fathers to be. It is because that father figure does a lot in the home. It directs, it protects, it tidies up the home in a special way, because when there is a father figure, the children tend to learn from the father. I tell you a story of a lady I met a couple of years ago. This lady came for Thanksgiving in the church. Then after the mass, she was so excited and happy, and I tried to know why the joy was so loud and well expressed. And she told me her story. The story was that she had a wonderful dad. A great dad, a loving dad, a caring dad. That when she was six years old, she was always praying to God for God to give her a husband like her dad. For her dad was very caring, very loving, and always taking them, showing them great love, and especially even their mom. And so from there, she was always praying and asking God, please, I need a husband like my dad. I mean, see how influential such is, that someone who is just 6 years old could begin to pray for a husband that is to come, say, in 20 years' time or 15 years' time. That is, she has tapped some good influence from the dad, and the dad is a figure that she wants to emulate, or he wants to be part of her forever, and that is why she prayed for such a husband. Now, the fathers are the pillars of the home, and one of the ways to make the home like the Holy Family of Nazareth, of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, is that the father must be devoted, committed to the service of God. And one of the ways is to constantly lead the family. For example, making sure that prayer is done always. Saint Pio told us, or always say, that prayer is the oxygen of the soul. And now, Penny Catechism, we always read that prayer is the raising up of our minds and heart to God. And this is very important. Prayer gives us comfort. Prayer gives us confidence. And if a father or a father to be develops the attitude of praying, it will also he will be also be able to inculcate this prayerfulness to the children or to people around him. And that means we must every day wake up, as we wake up, to thank God, call your family together, thank God that He has directed, He has guided, He has protected you throughout the course of the night, and ask Him to lead you throughout the course of the day, so that after the day's work, before you retire to bed, to come back again and say, yes, thank you, Jesus, for guiding us, for directing us, and for your presence in our lives. We're in a society that has been secularized. We're in a society that has been modernized, And so a lot of influences are coming up, like hedonism and consumerism. So if we can, at this point, especially fathers and fathers to be, think deeply about praying, about inculcating values, family values, societal values to our children, I think the society, the world will be a better place for us. And may God bless us through Christ our Lord. Amen.